Hello everyone, myself Dr. Meenakshi Kure. I am a nutritionist and practicing in Nerul, Navi Mumbai. Today we are going to learn 5 important things about nutrition. First, what is nutrition? Second, what are the 4 main food groups? Third, what is healthy diet? Fourth, how to incorporate healthy food items in our diet? And fifth, what are the consequences of unhealthy food on our health? So, let's understand what do you mean by nutrition. Nutrition means nourishment. Nutrition is the process of providing the food necessary for health and growth of the body. Nutrients that we obtain through food have vital effects on physical growth and development, maintenance of normal body function, physical activity and health. Nutritious food is thus needed to sustain life and activity. Our diet must provide all essential nutrients in the required amounts. Proper diet is essential from the very early stages of life for proper growth, development and to remain active. A variety of foods which are available and are within the reach of the common man can be selected to formulate nutritionally adequate diets. There are only 4 accepted basic food groups in India. A diet of foods from several food groups provides all the required nutrients in proper amounts. So here are 4 food groups on the screen. First is carbohydrates. This group includes all types of grains like wheat, bajra, jowar, maize, ragi, etc. We use these grains to make roti, bread, etc. This is a major food group which gives us energy. Diets rich in complex carbohydrates are healthier than low fiber diets based on refined and processed foods. Second food group is proteins. This food group is most important group. We get proteins from milk, milk products, eggs, fish, meat, and in all types of pulses like tuwar dal, moong dal, masoor dal, soya bean, etc. Proteins are primary structural and functional components of every living cell. Their important function is bodybuilding. Almost half the protein in our body is in the form of muscles and the rest of it is in bone, cartilage and skin. Third is vitamins and minerals. Vitamins like A, B, C, D, E, K are available in all types of vegetables and fruits and variety of nuts. Vitamins and minerals help us improve our immunity. They must be present in the diet as they cannot be synthesized in the body. Vitamins are essential for numerous body processes and for maintenance of the structure of skin, bone, nerves, eyes, brain, blood and mucous membrane. Last, that is 4th, is fats. Fats are a concentrated source of energy. All types of oils, butter, cheese, ghee, vegetable ghee are the sources of fats. Fats gives us energy and takes part in many essential processes in the body. An adequate diet providing all nutrients is needed throughout our lives. The nutrients must be obtained through a judicious choice and combination of a variety of foodstuffs from different food groups. I have made it simple for you to understand. Just remember that as you are in growing age, you should take frequent, small and nutritious 4 to 8 meals in a day to achieve a complete nutrition. You can see how to divide your daily meals in a day on the slide. After understanding how to follow pattern in a day, remember that along with carbohydrates and proteins, as discussed above, you children need to consume two more particular minerals in your daily diet. These are calcium and iron. Now you know the sources of carbohydrates and proteins. Let's see what are the calcium and iron rich food. Calcium, we get it in milk, all milk products like curd, yogurt, cheese, paneer. Soya bean, cornflakes, fish are the other sources. Ragi is one grain which is rich in calcium. Iron sources are dark green leafy vegetables, cornflakes, oranges, in non-veg food, fish, and specifically in organ meat. Few of you may not like to eat leafy vegetables, but try to develop healthy food habit. Try to eat leafy vegetables in different tasty form. Now, there is one more vitamin which is very important and we all need this. This is available freely in nature and makes our bones strong. Can you guess which is this vitamin? Yes, this is vitamin D. This is also called as sunshine vitamin. To get vitamin D abundantly, all you need is to play on the ground and do exercises in the sun, or at least expose your face and hands for 20 minutes in sun rays. Vitamin D is also available in foods like egg yolk, butter, cheese, but you need to consume it moderately. Now I will ask you one more question. Which is your favorite and tasty food? I can guess many of you must have remembered any one or more of these junk foods, right? You all know that junk food is not good for health. But do you know why it is unhealthy? There are three basic things which makes it unhealthy for us. Let's learn about this, which is a very important point for food items are handled unhygienically. Diet-related non-communicable diseases are commonly seen like diarrhea, jaundice, typhoid, etc. So we can easily avoid such diseases. Now, you know why junk and fast food is unhealthy. With increasing urbanization, energy-rich food containing higher amount of fat, salt and sugar, which also provide less dietary fiber and complex carbohydrates, are being frequently consumed. To avoid other health complications like headaches, weakness, hair fall, graying of hair, vitamin deficiencies, obesity, etc., and to always remain fit, we need to learn how to incorporate healthy food habits in our daily meals for better health. Right nutritional behavior and dietary choices are needed to achieve health. There are dietary guidelines by National Institute of Nutrition. Based on these guidelines, here is the summary of 10 points which is a take-home message for you all. Eat variety of foods to ensure a balanced diet. Eat plenty of vegetables and fruits. Ensure moderate use of edible oils and animal foods and very less use of ghee, butter, vanaspati ghee. Choose low-fat, protein-rich food such as lean meat, fish, pulses, and low-fat milk. Restrict salt intake to minimum. Minimize the use of processed foods rich in salt, sugar, and fats. Avoid overeating to prevent overweight and obesity. Ensure the use of safe and clean foods. Drink plenty of water and take beverages in moderation. Adopt right pre-cooking processes and appropriate cooking methods. And last, 10th point is incorporate above all healthy food habits along with daily exercises for healthy body and healthy mind. So in this session, you learned about nutrition, about four main food groups, what is the diet, how to incorporate healthy food items in our diet, and what are the consequences of unhealthy food on our health. So guys, stay fit, stay healthy. Thank you.